certainly back with Billy Squire on the stroke. What's this? Not something from Adam and the Ants, is it?
Oh.
No, in fact, it's the Meatloaf album. Thank you very much. I'll do anything these days. It sounds like me driving home without my driver or the taxi driver. Actually, this is the Meatloaf album. I showed you the cover a couple of weeks ago. I've now heard the album. I was very apprehensive because I thought that it might be sort of the scraps of the new Jim Steinman album, who wrote this album for Meatloaf. In fact, I can safely say I think this is better than Meatloaf's last album, Bat Outta Hell. It's quite a superb album. Meatloaf is singing better than ever. There are some great tracks on this. I congratulate not only Meatloaf, but Steinman for giving some superb songs to Meatloaf. You'll be very impressed with this album, and any of you freaks that were out there doing the Bat Outta Hell, you're going to love this one. I know one guy who's sort of... He goes to a party and he mimes all of Meatloaf. Well, you're going to have a ball with this one. All right, one particular group that aren't as big as Madness, but should be. I think they're not so much in the same vein. They're very good friends, and they've got a great song out now, The Specials with Ghost Town.
Bands won't play no more.
Too much fighting on the dance floor.
What an unreal group. Last week, of course, we had Mental As Anything on the show. They presented me with this album that had just been released called Cats and Dogs. It consists of 12 tracks, and I must admire this group. They've come out with two superb tracks already this year, and this album equals anything that you've heard of those two tracks. They're a very clever group. Each song is so different, and as I say, they're a group that not only are great live, but are also great on record, and congratulations to the boys. Watch out for them. Okay, there's been a lot of revivals and a lot of instrumental revivals coming on the charts, especially in England, and this is no exception. It's not a complete instrumental, but it's a very interesting group. 999 with Obsessed. There you go, 999. It sort of looks a cross between the Village People and Devo, but in fact it does work, and it's a very interesting clip, and we hope to show that in full. In fact, wait till you see Adam and the Ants there when you'll talk about clips. All right, hold on, I've got news for you later. This particular group, they've always been a delight to have on the show, and I wish they'd come back because they'd really liven up these studios. This particular album of Rose Tattoo is a ripper. It's great rock and roll. Angry has written most of the songs, or co-written most of the songs with the group, and I also must congratulate Vander and Young, who I thought had lost the touch with rock and roll. They produced this album, and it's a great rock and roll album. As I said last week, they're doing big business in England and Europe, and I'm sure once they come back, they are going to rock these studios and rock Australia like mad. That's Angry and the boys with Rose Tattoo. All right, one particular group, Duran Duran with Planet Earth. Planet Earth was a bit of a sleeper because it was released in January and has only really become a hit just recently. I don't think they're going to have any problems with Careless Memories. It's the new single. And incidentally, there is a long version of this one as well, already doing well in the dance places. Here is Duran Duran with Careless Memories.
How could I let you go without some feeling?
All right, that was Duran Duran. Earlier this week, I spoke to Rick Springfield in LA. He is absolutely knocked out that he's having the success on the Australian charts. He had the number one with Jesse's Girl in America, and he may, in fact, come out here early next year and could be doing our Rock Awards and being the host. So there's something up the sleeve. Talking about tours, the 3XY jocks have sort of been all going on tours lately, and a lot of them haven't come back. And I don't know why, because the station's top rating. But for one that did stay, just returned recently, here he is, John Peters, to give you a lot of tour dates. Take it over, John.
Gee, thanks, Molly. Leo Sayer's coming. October 14, Sydney Capital Theatre. October 17, Melbourne Festival Hall. Hobart Rest Point Casino on the 19th and 21st. 22nd and 24th at Alice Springs Casino. October 26th at the Adelaide Festival Theatre. And the 29th at the Perth Entertainment Centre. Doobie Brothers, October 24, Melbourne Festival Hall. The 28th, Adelaide Apollo Stadium, Brisbane Festival Hall on November 2nd, and the Horton Pavilion in Sydney on the 4th of November. And finally, Kraftwerk, September 16 and 17, Sydney Capitol Theatre, and the 18th at Melbourne Princess Theatre.
Okay, thanks very much, Johnny. Listen, one group that I keep talking about, they're going to tour here in February. They are without a doubt the hottest group around at the moment, and that's Devo. I've been telling you about their forthcoming album. Well, here it is. It's about to be released. It's just simply called Devo, and what a superb album this is. Now, I know I'm a bit of a Devo freak, and I thought that this may be a disappointment. There are some great tracks on this. Beautiful World, which could possibly be the next single, which we played a little of a couple of weeks ago, is only one of the tracks. This is an amazing album. There's actually a bonus single in this, Working in the Coal Mine, which is actually a track they did for a film, and that is a bonus single in the States, and it's actually a single in itself and already in the charts. And you get a poster as well. There's a huge poster. But also there's this little bit of information which gives you all the details of all the things a lot of people have been asking. Where do you get your Devo hat? Where do you get the T-shirts? Well, it's all there in this album, the information. So watch out for them. Now, next week we have Adam of Adam and the Ants comparing the show. Yes, indeed. It's your heart out, somebody. Anyway, and Adam and the Ants will be in fact performing two numbers on the show next week, Ant Music, and their new single, Prince Charming. But to give you a taste, sit back, have a look at this film. All you movie buffs, get out and have a look at it as well. This goes over the top. Here is Adam and the Ants with Prince Charming.
Don't you ever